Alright, welcome to a 1.9 item attribute tutorial. First off, you'll need a command block because these are very long commands. You won't be able to fit them in chat. Well, I guess you could if they're really short ones. But you'll need just basic command block. So when you type in a command, what I highly suggest is you go to Notepad. Because, let me get that off of there. Because in Notepad, you can very easily see what you're doing, and it's a lot more like modular copy paste kind of thing. So let's say you want, so you give at p, I have a little template right under this, I'm just going to copy off of that. Let's say you want chainmail leggings. I hope I spell all this right. We want one of them with zero damage. Alright, so this command so far will just give us, go back to Minecraft, this command so far will just give us a regular old pair of chain pants. So let's go back to Notepad. What if we want special stuff for it? So this is where it kind of turns into code. So you need two open close curly bracket. Inside of that, let's say if we want, we don't need this, but if we want to have a custom name or lore, the purple text, we need display colon. We need two more brackets, and it doesn't have to be spaced out like this. I'm just doing this because this is like normal coding kind of thing. I'll take out all the spaces and whatnot, make it just one line at the end. But if we want to have a name, we type display colon inside the curly brackets with name colon quotes inside the quotes. For these pants, I have them as level 1 speed pants. You can call it whatever you want. This is just what I'm, the name I'm using for my map. Now we could leave it at that, but if we want the purple text or whatever color it is, we need a comma and lore colon, whoops, it's not a colon, square brackets, and then inside that we need quotes and whatever you want the lore to be. Now if you want multiple lines, let's say this is lore 1, if we put a comma, more quotes, we can have a second line, we can have a third line. So let's see, let's see what this gives us so far. Now it doesn't matter that you have the lines and the tabs and whatnot, it'll still look, took out all that stuff, so done. What? Did I mess something up? Crap. space right there. Done. No? Yes. There we go. So now I have level 1 speed pants, lore line 1, lore line 2, lore line 3, and all these standard attributes. So now, let's go back to Notepad. If we want, we can just take this out. It's not necessary, but if we want, let me delete a little bit of this, if we want custom attributes, now, let me go all the way down here, the attributes are maximum health, so you can have a health increase, follow range, which is how far away zombies will attract, or track you, knockback resistance, which is measured 0 to 1 as percent, so 0.5 is percent, but it's not how far back you get knocked back, it's the percent chance you will avoid all knockback. I do have another video on that, I might have an annotation or something linking to it, I don't know. Movement speed, it's how fast you move. Attack damage, that's like on swords, you see like plus 5 attack damage. Armor, that's how many armor bars. Attack speed is how fast you can swing, and luck is a new one for dungeon chests and fishing. So I don't really know how that works because it like just came out. And the possible places you can have these in your main hand, your offhand, feet, legs, torso, head. So for armor, you're going to want these for feet, legs, torso, and head. And then for like swords or bows, you want main hand or offhand. Let's go back up to this. So if we want an attribute, we will say attribute modifiers colon, and then we want square brackets this time, and inside those square brackets, delete this, can't really see, we want, let's say, well, one problem with 1.9 is that you have to specify how much armor you want, because if you, like, say we just give it speed, it won't have any armor value. So in 1.9 you do have to give it the armor amount, so attribute, name, we will call it, or its actual name is generic.armor, comma, then name, I don't know why this is here, but the general, like, generally you just give it the same name as what it is. I think you can just call this whatever. I'm just going to call it generic armor again. Alright, and then comma, and amount, colon, and then how much you want. So let's say regular chain pants give 2 full armor bar thingies, so we'll say 4 half bars, and then operation. Now this is kind of a tricky one. The operation, there is, you can put 0, 1, or 2. If you put 0, it will say plus 4 armor. It's a standard, like, static increase or whatever. Whatever you want to call it. So that means it's just plus 4. Now, if you set it to 1, it'll be plus 4% additive. No idea really what that means. And then there's, if you set it to 2, that is plus 4% multiplicative. Or actually, that might be 400%. Yeah, that'll be 400% for both of those. But set it to 0, because that's pretty standard. Let me scroll over so I can see. Now we need UUID most and UUID least. So these numbers I usually just set to the same thing, and they can be, there's a pretty big range of numbers. So let's say we give this 1000, and then UUID least, colon, 1000. I always set them to the same. You can set them to different things. I don't really know what happens if you set it to other things. And then we need to specify what slot you want to have this effect applied. This is where I said, let's go over here. You have main hand, offhand, feet, legs, torso, and head. So if I want this attribute to be active when I have it in its proper slot, like when I'm wearing the chain pants, I want legs. Let's go back up to this. So let's slot legs. Alright, so if we take everything we have so far back to Minecraft, Control A, Control B, I guess this is, yep, I put a space there. Done. What? What did I get? Unbalanced curly brackets. No. Oh, maybe I didn't copy that last one. What? I didn't have it unbalanced. Let's see. See, this is why I like to do it in Notepad. See, I have a curly bracket here, lines up with this curly bracket. Bracket here, bracket here. Ah, you know what I didn't do? I need a comma between to separate the display and the attributes. Right here, I need a comma. Alright, now I can copy paste to here, Control A, Control V. Let's go home, space there, done. There we go, it was the comma. So now, as you can see, this looks pretty much the same as it was before, and it has when on legs plus 4 armor. So if I put this on and go to that, you see I have two big armor pieces, but it's measured in half, so I have 4 half pieces. Alright, let's go back to creative. Back to the text document. So now let's say I want to add movement speed. So what I need to do is go to the end of this line, put a comma, and go to the next line. And this is where it's very modular, because I can have armor, and then the very next line I just put speed, and then the next line, comma, down, brackets, I can put health, which is what I'm going to show in this. So just on the very last one, you can't have a comma. So let's say we want, we still need attribute name there, and we want generic dot movement speed quote, and we still need the name. Just generic dot movement speed, capital S, and then comma, the amount, and the operation, and the UUID. Let's just copy all of this. All right, take out that extra comma. So amount, let's do 20%. So 0.2 is 20% speed. And because we don't want to do add, here, let's go back to my little chart down here. So the default movement speed is 0.7. So if I wanted to add 20% speed, I would take 20% of 0.7 and add that to it. Now that's kind of a mess. So there is the multiply operand. Go. So if we want to use the multiply additive thing, we change this operation to a 1. And then here's where this gets a little confusing. The UUID most and least. If you want this to be like, if you want it to be effective, this UUID most and least needs to be a different number from this one, or else it will only take one of them, so we'll make this 1001. And that also goes for if you have, say, a hat that has movement speed, and you have pants that also have movement speed. They need to be different IDs, or else you will only get one of them. So now we have movement speed. We will take that, take it over to Minecraft, we go get rid of that, need a space there, done, and there we go, look at that. We have the name, the lore, plus 20% speed, plus 4 armor. Now if I put these on, see my FOV change, and I move a bit faster. So let me take this off. See, when I have it in my hand, it doesn't change any. When I put it on, I speed up. Alright. Now, by now you should be able to create like whatever you want in this. But we'll go ahead and add one more. So we need to go to the end of the line we just created, comma, next line. Let's say we want to give a downside. So we'll do the same. Here, let me just copy this whole line. There we go. Now we don't want speed. Let's say we want max health. Oop, capital H. Then comma, name, make this max health as well. Then let's say we want to have it take away half a heart. Actually, no, let's take away a whole heart. So we'll put -2 for 2 halves. In operation, we need this to be just additive, or in this case, subtractive, if that's a word. It's a totally a word. And we need to change the UUID. We'll make this 1002. And still in the like slot. And we need to take off the comma because that is the last one in the series. So now let's take all of this. Go back to Minecraft. Control A, Control V. Home. Put a space there. Done. And now we have plus 20% speed, minus 2 max health, plus 4 armor. So when I put this on, you can see right there, I am missing a heart. So that's what you can do for, there's the text document, for all these different things, you can increase it. One thing I didn't really, well, I guess this says the minimum is 0, but I guess that is the absolute value. So you can do -2 for this, like I just did, and it'll still work. So I guess this real, the actual minimum is the negative of this, but whatever. So if you do -20, you will have 0 hearts. Now you still live because the game hasn't updated that you're basically dead, but as soon as you take damage, you will die. And then, say, follow range. Well, I already explained all this at the beginning, but you should be able to build whatever kind of gear you want with this. Let me go back up to this. Now, if you don't want to have it in this kind of format, you don't actually need any of the tabs, or you get rid of all the tabs and the spaces that you don't need. Scoot this over so you can see. Alright, so that is everything I just typed. Oh, I didn't type this. You didn't see that. Everything I just typed, all in one line. Control C. Back to Minecraft. Can't open it in. There we go. Control A, V, home. So yeah, I put the space in there. Done. And same thing. So, I suggest you go to Notepad. I'll try and remember. I will put this text document in the description so you can just copy paste. And you should be able to build stuff like these pens. This is way too long of a video, but this is in version 15W44B. So it still should work in like 1.8 and stuff, but in 1.8 you don't need to specify like feet and head and all that stuff. So anyway, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.